example for, but this changes a little bit. Let's say I have R of t equals, and let me use this notation, cosine t, sine t, and t. Are you okay with that notation as well?
So for the old problem, you don't find the y and z. You don't compare them.
It's still hard, right?
So it says the point is just finding the intersection between those two points. Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
What about the other one, but it's not touching? Doesn't the possibility that the last one I will touch that intersection?
Which last one?
The y and z.
It should satisfy also. Yeah, it should. I mean, you can also get the cylinder y equals z to the t to the whatever, right? But it's a fraction, so I got to skip that. Okay? It's easier to graph the cubic and the parabolic. Okay? Next example I want to explain because it has a lot of practical applications and it's kind of cool. Okay? So a variation of example 4, I have R of t is cos t, sine t, and t. Just to show you, you can write it without the IJK. What are you reading from this? What parametric equations can you read from this?
X
equals cos t, right? Y equals sine t, and z equals t. Looks like that's what you have. All right. I remember when we were doing chapter 13, those of you who are my students, we were very happy with cos t and sine t, right?
Yeah.
Why?
The circle.
Circle. Can you explain how did that become a circle?
It's x squared plus y squared.
If you look at these two, x squared plus y squared is going to be what?
One.
Cos squared t plus sine squared t, which is?
One.
Right? So basically what you get is a circle in 2D, but because now we're in 3D, what is this? It's still a circle, it's a circular, what? It's not a sphere because D is absent, what is it? It's a circular cylinder. You will get this, don't worry. It's only week 3. Okay. Is it 4 already? We have a lot of time to figure it out. Where should I draw the circular? How should I draw the circular cylinder? Well, yeah, it's on the x. The circle is on the xy plane, right? Okay, so I have the circle on the xy plane. And the circular cylinder is drawn how? You just extend it on z, top and bottom, right? Let's see, did I say anything about t? Did the book say t should be something, or can it just be anything? T greater than or equal to 0. If we just say that I want t to be greater than or equal to 0, am I done? No, but do I want to extend this below?
No.
So that's it, right? It's just sitting on the floor, holding up indefinitely, okay?
Here represents the direction, right?
We haven't drawn the curve, okay? No curve yet. Remember, we're looking for the curve. What we have drawn is the circular cylinder. So the curve we're looking for should satisfy this. I was able to show that this is actually a circular cylinder. What does that tell me? So now what I'm saying is, oh, at least I know that that curve has to be where? This information, will I have any reason to say, oh, maybe I have a curve here?
Yeah.
Really? Can I draw my curve here? Because the fact that you said the curve has to satisfy, right? X squared plus y squared equals 1 tells you that what? The x and y coordinates of that curve should satisfy that circular cylinder equation. You understand?
Yes.
So now you know that the curve is confined where?
It's
confined. Not just the first, but it's. No, it's not just the first octant. It's confined on that cylinder. Do you get it? Because the x and y should satisfy the equation of the cylinder.
Does the stipulation of t be greater than or equal to 0 not confine the whole curve just
to the first octant? Let's see that. I don't think so. Let's play with it now. So yeah, you're right, because the cylinder is really everywhere, including the back of the room, right? And so on and so forth. Okay. It doesn't, because remember the behavior of cosine and sine. Cosine and sine, are they always positive for t greater than or equal to zero? Doesn't matter, right? Doesn't cosine and sine range in value from what to what? Negative 1 to 1, right? So you can have negative answers for x, y. So you can go to the back of this room, to that room, you can go to this room, right? The only thing you cannot go to is what? Under, right? Okay? So far, are we okay? So you know that that curve has to be drawn somewhere here, okay? You want to try doing it? So let's try it. First point, if t is 0, what do I get? If t is 0, I get x is 1, y is 0, and z is 0. So where is that? I'm going to have this point, right? 1, 0, 0. Okay? What's another nice value that we can try?
Pi over 2.
When t is pi over 2, what happens to cosine?
It's 0.
0. This will be 0.
Yeah.
This will be 1, and this will be pi over 2. Pi over 2 is like 1.57, right? Let's try. X is 0. Y is 1, right? And then it has to go up a little bit, 1.57, so it will go there. And remember how the unit circle behaves, there will be intermediate values here, right? Okay? So you connect that. And then what happens is that t increases in value all the time, right?
Yes.
So this will go what?
Spiral.
It will go up. Will it loop somehow and go like this? It has to loop. Am I doing a good job? It's all right, right? You understand what I'm saying, right? It will be like a spring. It's a spiral. The name for this is actually it's called a helix. Okay?
So we're just looking at the endpoints of the vectors that are created.
Exactly, because remember that the vector value function is we're just looking at the endpoint.
So it's hollow, it's not like...
It's hollow, yes, it's not solid. That's a good point, right? Remember, it's just the endpoints we're tracing. At zero, you go there, then you go there, then you go like this. So we're tracing the curve. And the curve is just inside this. It's inside, it's just on that thing. All right, are you getting it? And that's a helix, which you see every day. I don't know if anybody has a spiral notebook. You have one. You think that looks like a helix? And you can
give... like vectors coming out to each.
Yeah, and also they say like the DNA model is a double helix. What does double helix look like? Yeah, two intertwined, right? That's like... So this is nice applications I don't know about, so... But that's just to explain the notion of curve. Are you getting it?
Yes.